four crimes which come under Rome. And that is very important to remember, that there are only four crimes or offences that come under the jurisdiction of Rome. And what are they? First, the crime of genocide. And then crimes against humanity. Thirdly, war crimes. And finally, the crime of aggression. Now, if I just state those, you will know immediately, anybody with half a brain will be aware that we are talking of the most serious crimes of the world. So, for example, if war is declared, although the Agong is the supreme commander of our armed forces, the decision to go to war is always made by the Prime Minister, the Cabinet, and the Minister of Defence. And operationally, it will be the generals who run the war, or the admirals if there's a navy involved. So if Malaysia commits war crimes in a war that Malaysia may enter into tomorrow, the people who may be vulnerable to an ICC prosecution will be the Prime Minister, the Cabinet, the Minister of Defence, the generals, but never the King. Never the King, because he's a constitutional monarch.
Homosexuality is not a crime against humanity, as far as I know. The Article 7 of the Rome Statute deals with persecution, not prosecution, persecution against any identifiable group or collectivity on political, racial, national, ethnic, cultural, religious, gender, or other grounds that are universally recognized as impermissible. And by the way, how does it define gender? It says very clearly, and the term gender is to refer to two sexes, male and female. This is what the statute says. Good news for those who intend to commit genocide. Yeah, good news. Good news. Good news is this. The statute is not retrospective. So if you have committed any of these in the past, you are still okay. If you have beaten up someone in the bar, or you have punched a few reporters, you are still okay. You are still okay.
That Islam condones heinous crimes like genocide, war crimes, crimes against humanity and aggression, this is a total misinterpretation and an insult to Islam, which is a religion of peace, compassion, and mercy.
I'm the odd man out. Sebabnya, saya seorang, saya bukan lawyer. Dan ini memberikan saya satu keuntungan. Keuntungan untuk bercakap daripada perspektif yang lain. Perspektif saya ialah perspektif sains sosial. Di antara negara-negara yang mempunyai raja, hampir semuanya mereka exit dan ratify. Cuma di Malaysia ini raja-raja takut untuk ratify. Mungkin mereka telah disalah nasihatkan oleh setengah-setengah hendak membuat apa saja bagi memperkuatkan kedudukannya. Salah satu daripadanya ialah dengan menolak Statute Rome. Dan ini yang sedang berlaku sekarang ini. Pertentangan elit, tradisional dan modern akan bertambah kuat.
Terima kasih kepada empat orang profesor ini. Tidak dibentangkan, intellectual discussion seperti ini tidak akan berlaku.
Dan hari ini kita membincangkan perkara yang ilmiah. Saya tak tahu you all semua ilmiah, you all cakap semua. Kita ini adalah orang yang educated. Tetapi tadi you menggelar orang lain stupid. Menggelar empat profesor itu stupid. Dia sepatutnya boleh bercakap. Dan you pun boleh bercakap. Tapi tak perlu menggelarkan orang stupid, kangkung, tak perlu pun. Sebab apa? Ilmiah. You present your fact, dia pun nak represent dia punya facts.
Saya kata okay. Presentation dia stupid.
No, kenapa bukan you? Stupid. Yang lain pun cakap stupid. Yang lain pun cakap kangkung. Kita semua kena hormat menghormati di antara satu sama lain. Ini Malaysia baru. Maksudnya you boleh cakap you punya fakta, no problem.
Okay.
Tapi jangan gelar orang kangkung, jangan gelar orang bodoh.
Ya. Yeah.
Okay, satu lagi.
Saya nak minta satu lagi. Yes, I can. Can I
read it off?
Can you? Okay, we have heard your viewpoint.
Okay.
Who's the next speaker? Forum here that we are having today is very unique. It's very unique. I was a professor here for many years, almost 17, 18 years in this faculty. We were not allowed to have any forum of this kind.